Hey, this is YBR with Beam and Chi driving. We're gonna roll now. And by roll, I mean we're gonna roll in my steamroller. Well, not my steamroller, somebody else's steamroller that was made for Beam and Chi drive that I can drive. And I know you guys all came here to see this thing for its amazing drift abilities, because that is what steamrollers are known for. So let's just go right into it and start drifting this thing. You know, obviously you're not here to see crashes or anything. You're here to see this thing get drifted and show how amazing of a drifter it is. And it is like a drifting machine, man. Once it gets up to speed, oh, you're going to see some sparks, I swear. You're going to see some sparks, literally. See, when you're up to speed, about 22 miles per hour, that's drift time. Are you ready for this? Here we go, drift time. Turning in tight, sparking on the wheels. Counter steer, and no, that didn't work. Okay, this thing isn't a good drift car. I admit, I lied to you. I think it's even front-wheel drive, technically, so yeah, that's probably really not a good drift car. But it is good for what you think it'd be good for. Crushing things, yes, that's what it's good for. So unfortunately, I would say whenever you use it, though, you need to immobilize the car against, like, a wall or something. Because if you try to do something like this, it's not going to be happy. The truck will just keep bumping away. It's like, come here, I want to eat you! And then it just goes in the other direction. So what you need to do is you need to go find something to, like, lean the car on. So, like, over here, we could just lean it on that block and then put the steamroller up here and then roll into it from here. And that makes it where the car can't escape. It's like there is no escape for the car. It will get crushed. Steamroller, stop rolling on your own. Oh, did I mention the steamroller literally has no brakes? Like, it doesn't have any brakes. It just doesn't. Stop, steamroller! No, don't do it! Oh, God, it won't stop. I can't stop it. It's just, like, it's just plowing through my poor truck. Jeez, steamroller, calm down. Why are you hurting my truck like this? Alright, so here we go. We're just gonna roll right into the truck, alright? So let's go and make sure we got lots of momentum. So it has no brakes, though, because supposedly it breaks things, because the brakes break things. Ha ha! Because the wheels are so heavy. So anyways, it is just 4x slow-mo. And oh no, we're actually going under it still. Oh, that didn't happen before. What's up with that? I mean, we did crush it. Now we're stuck inside of it a little bit, so let's go and just reset it. How's the truck? Do you still run? Oh my goodness, it actually runs still. That is something else. That thing looks, like, look how bent it is. And up, the steamroller's just like, hey, what are you doing? It's just rolling along all on its own with no brakes. Like, look, I'm holding the brakes. Do you seem like we're slowing down? No. So, right now, all we can do is condense the, okay. Oh, wow. We condensed that car. Like, that's a shape I'm not sure if I've ever seen before. Like, all the hundreds of crashes I've done in Beam and Chi Drive, I do not think I've ever seen a car get crushed like that. Oh, and now it's getting crushed more. Hello, steamroller. Yes. Just wreck up my whole car even more. It's already so ruined anyways. Who cares? All right, here's an idea, though. Since that one you saw, I couldn't get over the car, let's try something it could probably get over. We're going to use the bolide here, and I figure this thing's such a wedge shape. I don't know why I went through all the trouble to pick the 350 GTR, but anyways, this thing is such a wedge shape to it that I'm pretty sure the steamroller will climb right up on this thing and just crunch it. Just crunch, 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 and the bolide will be bits. And by the way, the reason I'm just using this block is because it's convenient. You could use a wall, you could use whatever. In fact, actually, you know what? Let's use that glass wall over there. That would probably look pretty cool. We'll do that instead. Plus, that means we get more speed for the steamroller. Ow. The door just went, hope it closed. That was funny looking. It's just like the car waved at me or something. Like a real quick, you know, stealthy wave or something. I hear the steamroller coming. Where is it? It's like, it's coming. Like, you hear it, and it's revving up so hard, and it's accelerating for so long, and it's going 10 miles per hour. It's like, oh, okay. Yeah, that's so threatening. Let me just walk out of your way. It's like, I'm gonna get you. Oh, I'm so slow. I can't get you. I'm tired. Come on, steamroller, max speed, 20 miles per hour. We're going to hit that thing at 20 miles per hour. That's some good speed for a steamroller, you know? Here we go. We're going to just run right over that thing. Look at that. We just rolled right up on it. And, well, let's look at the car. Well, look, it's a convertible now. How convenient. Now my floor is my roof. You know, yeah, when you sit down, you sit on the metal and it hurts and the glass hurts and everything hurts. But isn't that convenient? Maybe we'll do that again. But try doing it from the rear end, see if that can be done from the rear end as well. Let's see, like, how big of a slope of the car, or wedge-shaped car, do you need? Because that car is a wedge, you know, from the front. How about the back? Urgh. Oh, goodness, that was glitchy. Things are getting a little glitchy here. They're stuck inside of each other. So let's go and just respawn them both. Oh, what'd you do? What did I do to you? I'm so sorry. Like, the back end is just bleh, just exploded. Front end's like, I'm okay. Oh, that's a good idea. That's what we're going to do. We're going to totally just annihilate the front end of this, but we're going to keep the back end safe so that way it can still drive, hopefully. Hopefully. I say hopefully. We'll see what happens, you know? So this one, we don't actually want to go at it fast. We want to go slow just to make sure we don't go too hard. We just gotta make sure we get up on it. That's all we gotta do. So I'm gonna just speed at it, then reset it once we're near it. I think if I stay a little bit offset of it and then reset it right there, it should be lined up perfect. Here we go. It's gonna crush the front end a little bit, just a little bit. Come here, just a little bit. Oh, we're going a little too slow. No, don't get stuck in me. You think you are getting stuck inside of me. There we go, that's it. Just like that. All right, we can go a little harder on it. You see, no brakes though. We're trying to like go forward, and it's like, hold on, you gotta wait for the momentum to stop, or you could use manual transmission and shift into first, be like, go, and like ruin your transmission or something in the process if you were to do that in real life. But that's okay when you don't have brakes, you know. That's the difference between life and death. All right, here we go. Crunch. How about that? All right, do you still run? Oh, it runs great, probably even. I don't even think it... Wait. No, it does pull to the left a bit. Look at that, though. It's like the front end is just totaled out. Oh, jeez. My bumper just came off. I drifted too hard. I wasn't even meaning to drift. I just accidentally drifted, and then my bumper came off. All right, you ready for round two, then? How about we crush you like this, then, instead, you know? Crush you like that. There we go. Round two! Fight! It's not even a fight, it's a murder. A big, entertaining murder, at least. That's mean. That's like a thing a psychopath would say. Turns out I'm a psychopath. Oh well. What's she gonna do? Oh, that's great. Oh, I'm flipping the car. Don't want to do that. Reset that. How you doing, car? Still drives. The right wheel is, well, I don't know, actually. It might be okay. It didn't seem like it was... Yeah, but look at the front end. It's just like it's so broken that it's starting to get glitchy because I can just keep crushing it over and over again. But the rear end's fine. The rear end's fine, so it just keeps driving. The engine's not crushed. All right, let's get the rear end now. You've had long enough, car. It's your time to die. Oh, I just crushed it. Does it still drive now? It still drives? Oh, man. This is the world's most durable bolide I've ever seen. Like, these cars are not, like, really, like, super fragile or anything, but this one is ridiculous. It's like, you can't kill me. That's it. It's time to kill you. Are you dead yet? Look at that. The wheels still spin somehow. What is this nonsense? Alright, we're gonna go in for the high-speed collision now. We gotta kill this car, man. This car is insane. This thing needs to be blown up as hard as I can. We're gonna just come flying at it at like 70 miles per hour. I don't care. 17 miles per hour, not 70. Because that's, you know, this thing can't go 70 miles per hour. It'd be cool. But it can't. Good night! There's no way that's driving. What? No way! How is it still spinning the wheels? Like, that is just so ruined, and it's just like, it's not giving up. Well then, I know you can't drive, but you're still not dead to me yet. So, we're gonna do one more crush. If it survives this crush, it gets to live. It gets to live. All it has to do is survive one more crash. That's it. Because this thing is so utterly obliterated, it's absurd. Alright, did you survive it? What in the world? I know I didn't use cheater transmission on it, but it still somehow runs. That's weird. I'm chalking that up to a glitch. How about, let's do something else. Ooh, where's the pigeon? Pigeon, there you are. Pigeon! Oh, look how cute it is. Run this thing over accidentally. So small. What's it look like from the inside when you're crushing something, you know? What do you see? You're like, And you're driving along, you're talking to your coworker because you're walking, you know, you're driving about a walking pace. So you're like, hey, how you doing, Dad? Okay. Yeah, doing okay. And then you hear a boom. It's like, what was that? Oh, I don't think I hit anything. Oh, wait, what's that over there? Oh, crap. I just killed him. You know, it's like, oh, man, I just killed a guy. What? Oh, physics broke. I broke it so hard, physics broke. That happens. I don't know why the other car is spawning on top of him, though. I didn't have it spawning there before. That was weird. Okay, there we go. Everything should be fixed. Oh, no, it's doing a crazy glitchy thing, which I don't know how to fix, where it goes freeze on freeze, freeze on freeze, freeze on freeze, freeze forever. Oh, yeah, see, you see on the edges it's going dark and then white? It's just freezing and unfreezing physics, and indefinitely it does that, it seems, sometimes. So we're just going to pop back out, or pop right back in then, and that'll fix everything right back up. All right, so, are we good to go? Okay, we're good to go. So now let's do a high-speed collision, crashing into the steamroller, with like a bolide, and see what happens then. Because the other one, yeah, it's like, you know, we were doing sitting duck. What if the car's actually moving fast? I want to see, can we get the bolide moving fast enough where we just kind of slide under it and still drive? That'd be interesting, don't you think? So that's the goal. I don't think it'll happen, but if it does, that'd be cool. So we're going to go ahead and put it right about here. That should be good. Steamroller is ready. Make this the fancy old bolide. Make it race edition, or the fast edition, I should say. Turn the AI to chase me. And we should be good to go. Hopefully the AI is able to control that steamroller okay. And if they are, happy times are ahead. Or sad times, depending on what your definition of times that are happy and sad are. Alright, so we're going to use 8 times slower on this. And make sure I get it nice and lined up. That is perfect alignment. Okay, here we go. Oh, it just gets crushed. It couldn't go under it. I was wondering if it would work like being able to go under it. It just got crushed. And it just keeps getting crushed. AI is just like, I win. They just stopped. Like, I win. Oh, now they're pulling back to try to shred me. Chill out, man. You are a murderer. Murdering machine. Alright, it's somehow the wheels still spin, but it's not moving nowhere. Alright, let's try a different car. What else can we wreck up? We already did the pigeon. What about the Corvette? The nice thing is I could just spend all time just setting this up and still turn around, and then the roller's just getting started, you know? Alright, here we go. We're going to try something different. We're going to try just sliding into it and then... Like, oh no! Crash. Alright, chill out. How's the car look? Oh my goodness gracious. That car's dead. You know what though? The passenger might be okay. The driver's obviously dead. The driver's super dead. But the passenger may have lived that. Look. He may have been okay, because there wasn't that many G's experienced, I don't think. We only crashed at him at, like, 30 miles per hour, maybe? Maybe it was faster, I don't know. But yeah, that's not bad. What is the steamroller doing? You're going the wrong way, dude. You're gonna use your drift abilities, right? Here we go. Drift in 3, 2, 1. Initiate drift! Oh, God, we turned too tight. Like, the steering on this thing is so slow. It's like, it's so... Like, I'm not, like, turning it slow on purpose. Like, all right, I'm going to tell you when I start turning left, okay? So I'm going to start turning left right now. I'm turning left now. Look how slow it goes. Like, oh, I'm turning left. And then it drifts. Because these are wheels that are made out of, like, steel or concrete or whatever. Steamrollers are made out of. Somebody will come out. They're made out of exactly 20% this material, 18% this material, and blah, blah. Somebody's going to say that, but you know what I mean. Crush. Alright, so, because I know somebody will ask for it, let's try dropping the steamroller on a car. Let's just drop it on a car. It's going to be like, here's steamroller, here's car, splat, and rest in peace car. So what we'll do is we'll put the steamroller wee up here, wee, around there, and that will fit here. Oh my goodness, that is a tight fit, but it fits. Whoa. Alright, we're good. Now we gotta put a car under it, and we're doing it, like, you know, legitimately. We're not just gravity dropping it. We're actually driving it onto it, dropping it, you know? Just because it's a little more fun. Alright, so hopefully, right about a little more. Okay. Hopefully that's far enough away. How's it look from up here? Maybe put it back a little more. How about there? All right, that looks good. Drop the steamroller. Oh no. Maybe if we go a little faster. We'll roll forward first and then roll backwards. Come on, steamroller. Oh no. Oh no, steamroller. I'm so sorry. He's wrecked. Now we gotta move the car backwards a bit. Maybe about right there. Oh. Nope, it's got stuck. You gotta have somebody holding the reverse on the gas and stuff. Come on! It's missing it. Oh, so close. Alright, there is perfect. Right where it's at right now is perfect. Here we go! It's like a sumo wrestler move, you know? Like, let me just do this like crazy suplex looking thing and I may have killed myself in the process, but I got that car. I really got that car. Oh, it still drives. It still drives. Oh my goodness, this is beautiful. This thing still drives. Look at it. It still drives though. That is. I love when that happens. I absolutely love cars when it's like the half of it's ruined and the other half is perfect. Oh, by the way, this thing is like, you know, as good as a front-wheel drive car can get for drifting. It's like, you know, when you get those McDonald's trays and you throw them under your car and then you have an instant front-wheel drive drift car. Am I talking from experience? It depends. Is McDonald's going to sue me? But it's just like that, really. I wasn't the one who did it, okay? Somebody else did it and I was there to watch. That's the truth. Don't sue me, McDonald's. Give me your trays, though. So that's crazy. It's still driving. That's just beautiful. What else can we do? Ooh, I know what we could do. We could try shaving. Yes, I do mean like, you know, shaving your face and your legs or whatever you shave, your armpits, your head. There's some other places you could shave as well, but I don't feel like saying them. You know what I'm talking about, though. All we're gonna do though is we're gonna put the car on a low ramp, and then we're gonna just take the thing right over it and try to shave the roof off. And see what happens. You know, it's gonna look weird because the roofs aren't made to be shaved off, but I wanna see what happens. So park it right there. How you doing, Roller? You just doing some of that yoga? You know, just relaxing, yoga-ing out and stuff. Okay, good. Yoga's over. Now it's time to crash cars, okay? So we're gonna put you right here, flip you out, and we're gonna crash the car now. Alright, full speed ahead, Caterpillar. Meow. Wait, caterpillars don't meow. Why did I say meow? It's because it says cat on the side. I know, I'm like, wait a minute, that made no sense. What made me meow? What made me go meow? It's just because I'm weird. Like, I want to meow. I'm going to meow right now. I don't care. Nobody tells me what to do. Alright, how'd it do to the car? Oh, we actually got it decently. We need a taller car, though. That's what we need. We need a taller car. Like the off-road truck. That'll be tall enough. Where is the off-road truck? Ooh, straight through a box van. It literally will go straight through this thing, I bet. You're like, oh, I hit a box van? Oh, I didn't know that. Just drives right through it, you know? It's just gonna go right through it. It's gonna be great. All right, here we go. The sad part is it takes so long to get started moving. It's like, we gotta start way back here, and we gotta wait, like, come on, accelerate max power, and you just yell at it to go faster, and it's like, oh. Why are steamrollers so slow? I want a steamroller that can go highway speeds, you know? Just driving along my steamroller on the freeway without a care in the world, you know? Here we go. Can we drive right through it? Let's find out. And I switched cameras because this one has a slow-mo. Oh, yeah, it just drove right through it. It's just like, I don't care about you. It just drives right through it. Just tore the box part apart. Oh, man. And it keeps driving. It's like, I'm going to take you along with me now. You are now part of the steamroller. Look at that thing. It just tore the box off. Like, the whole box thing just disappeared. It got hit so hard. All right, what if you try to park it inside of the box? Oh, we got to try that. Like, it's just, what if we try that? Just see what it does. Got to see what it does. So weird how it does that. You like put in parking and then it's like it rolls around still. It's like the parking brake's on. The car should be in neutral or park. Why are you still rolling around? Chill out, car. You shouldn't be moving. It's illogical that you're moving. You should be an immobile, stationary vehicle that I can crush easy. Okay, here we go. I'm just gonna try to load my steamroller into my moving van, and oh no, I'm going way too fast. Oh, it actually loaded in. Look, how perfect. Now let's drive it home. This truck's like, I can't, this is heavy. Are you insane? Do you know how heavy this thing is? Just totally just blew up the truck, though. It's crazy. Just crazy. Alright. Let's see. What else could we possibly... Steamroller versus steamroller? I think so. Let's see what... I don't think it'll be really interesting. But it might be. Like, if it is interesting, it'll be really interesting. Or it'll just be really boring. We're gonna figure out which. No brakes! No brakes whatsoever! Alright, AI off, apply, AI, chasing player, go. So we should have a combined speed of about 40 miles per hour, so I'm thinking. So that'll still be a pretty fast collision. All things considered, this car has slow-mo on it, let's just watch. I bet it's gonna jiggle like jello because they're both so heavy. Oh! Wasn't that interesting? It had potential, but it was Yeah, here's another idea. What if we try this on other gravities? So let's say, moon gravity. Does that make it like a race car? No, it just has no traction now. It's like, can't move first. Mars? I was hoping maybe it would weigh less and it would still have all the same power, so it actually would go faster. Not really. What about Jupiter? Can you drive in Jupiter with this thing? See, now it weighs even more. Now it's just like, I will wreck everything in my path. Except everything else is heavier too, so it really doesn't matter. Can it drive in sun gravity? No. It's just like, I give up. Ugh, it just collapsed on itself. Like, I can't do this. Are you insane? I give up. Negative Earth? Sun! Aw, I really ruined it now. I really ruined it now. Oh, goodness. Alright, so let's, Well, unfortunately, but I'm doing this because I know somebody will say it otherwise. We'll try ramming this into the H-Cube, but the H-Cube's actually going to be a poor, innocent H-Cube in this situation because I don't believe... Do I even have it installed? I thought I did. Yeah, I do. But it's not going to stand a chance, unfortunately, because I don't have the thrusters functioning right now. I did something to break it where I can't drive the H-Cube, and it's unfortunate. I got to fix that eventually. But you can't drive it, so it's a sitting duck. And if you want to see the H-Cube stand a chance, I could do another video. Probably just another H-Cube video in general. There's a few things I could do with that thing. But for now, let's just do this. Let's see what happens. The 8,000 kilogram H-Cube versus the... I don't know how much this weighs. Steamroller. Ooh. Ooh, that's a fair fight right there. We're going to have to come back to this later. I got to fix my H-Cube up, and we're going to have to... We're gonna have to make another video for that. Like I said, there's a few things I want to do the H-Cube with, so we'll do that later. I think that's good enough with this getting to wreck cars. It's time for the steamroller to get a taste of its own medicine, you know? I mean, sure, I've wrecked it a bunch, but it's really annihilating those cars out here, so we need to really annihilate it. Let's go to Brutal Slope first. It's gonna go Leap of Death first, but let's try Brutal Slope. I really don't know exactly what it'll do at Brutal Slope, because it might... Well, I just don't know how fast it'll go. And I have no idea how well it'll handle the speeds. It might be like, we're going 50 miles per hour, we're tumbling, flipping over, and... Yeah. You know, I don't know. We'll see. Okay. Let's go ahead and get the roller, steamroller. Oh, the colors don't do anything as far as I know. I never actually tried the colors, but I don't think they do anything. I had to guess. Yeah, did it make it slightly reddish, or am I just imagining things? Hold on. Did I just make it slightly reddish? Am I going crazy? I'm going crazy. It's the same color as before. Alright, here we go. They're gonna try going down this thing. Let's see what happens. Alright, it's going up to speed. And And one of the things I should test is when you're topping out at, like, past red line and stuff, are you better off to put it in the neutral or just keep holding the accelerator? Like, I swear I did a test before and I thought, like, it was better to just keep holding it, the accelerator. But I can't remember if that was, I actually did that or if I just imagined it because I'm crazy. All right, let's get a convertible steamroller because, you know, that's what the sunburnt construction workers really want. They want some way to get sunburnt even faster and harder. So I don't have much control going through this, by the way. It is very minimal control. We just blew up one of the whole rollers. It's gone. And look at this thing. This thing has, like, so much force behind it right now because it just weighs so much. Even though it's only moving at 40 miles per hour, that thing will just crunch anything up. So yeah, it just kind of gets glitchy just because I think the wheels are so heavy. The game doesn't know quite what to do about it. It's like, why is this wheel so heavy? This game is not designed to have wheels that are, you know, 5 tons or whatever they weigh. I don't know how much they weigh. I'm just guessing, you know? Actually, that's not even a guess. That's a random number. If I had to guess, I wouldn't guess that high. Seems a bit too high. Anyways, we're going to try to hit the wall, but I make no guarantees here. If we miss the wall, we'll miss the wall, and we'll just go to Leap of Death. We'll see what happens. Come on, turn, please. Now turn the other way. Look at this drift machine. It's like, let me just drift the whole way up. That's not even drifting, I know. Come on, turn right. Okay, go to that left wall. Don't turn right. Go left. That's good enough for me. I didn't do slow-mo just because I don't think you'd see anything interesting. Well, I take that back. It may have been interesting. Now that I'm thinking things over, I'm like, that probably would have been interesting. So I'm like, oh, gotta do it again. I lied to you guys. There's no, like, instant replay button, you know? Show me that again in slow-mo. Click. Oh, be nice and convenient, wouldn't it? So yeah, but this thing is just going sideways the whole way, it seems like, with me behind the wheels. Like, we're going sideways. Does the wheel actually turn? Oh, it doesn't. Oh, man, that makes crushing cars so much... Doesn't affect it at all. I don't really care. Alright, so let's see what happens. This is a different angle, but that's okay. How does it react? Oh, weird. The seat was bending before it even crashed. See, I don't think this thing is really made for crashing. Oh, God. Oh, goodness. I just broke everything. What I was saying, I don't think this is made for crashing. I think it's more made for making other things get crashed, you know? I mean, yeah, you can crash it, but, it's not made for that, you know? But, you know, it's like, well, we gotta do it. You can't have a car video and not crash it. You just can't. You can't. Right, so steamroller, and we are just about done with this thing, so let's get this thing down to hill. I wonder if this would make a good off-road car. Not like in the sense of, oh, this is the best off-road car ever, just in the sense of, hey, look, it can actually make it up this hill that most cars can make it up, you know? I don't think I'll bother testing it, it's just a random curiosity. So this thing, it should pretty much be, like, accelerating the whole time. I don't think it'll reach, like, a terminal velocity of sorts with how much mass it has, like a lot of cars usually might do. So the first collisions won't actually be any faster, but the last ones might be. Look at that roller, man. It is, like, falling. It's actually falling out of the thing, it looks like. Speaking of which, we never hit the brake all brake boost button. We'll have to do that. Or deflated the tires. I don't know if you can actually deflate them, like, in real life. As far as I know, they are not rubber, so I don't think you can deflate them. I mean, as far as I know, they're not rubber, at least. I'm not a construction machines kind of... Oh, we broke the game. I'm not that knowledgeable in construction machines. I'll say that now. What happens if we hit deflate tires? Oh, it looks like it did move a little bit, didn't it? Watch. And just watch the tires. Okay, ready? Deflate tires in 3, 2, 1, now. See? Something happened. And brake all brake groups doesn't seem to do anything. It just holds itself together still. It's like, I don't care about your little brake all brake groups. I'm a steamroller. Can you do a barrel roll or something? Oh, nope. All right, that is the steamroller. I do want to get this thing maybe in a against that HQ. Like I said, oh my goodness, it just crunched. So we'll probably have a separate video. I'm planning to do a video with the H-Cube, just a couple of tests I wanted to do with it, so. Yeah, see that again there, but if there's anything else you guys want to see with the steamroller, feel free to request it, and, you know, if there's anything that it seems like you guys are, you know, have a few people interested in, or I think would be fun, or whatever, you know, I'll probably make a video for it. So, until next time, this has been YBR. I'll see ya. Whoa, getting crazy up in here, but I'll see ya.